Ayo.
Ayo.
I like that that's like one of David Bowie and Queen or Freddie Mercury's like most like famous songs is them just going,
Ayo. Oh, I thought you were saying that song was one of theirs. And I was like, no.
What?
But I got you.
Yeah. Or not Deo.
Yeah,
that's,
yeah, yeah.
That's a Harry Nilsson, I think.
I feed deadly black tarantula.
All right.
Well, now we can begin.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello. Welcome back to the Level 7 broadcast, where this time we're going to talk about the ever so influential time traveling limited run games 3 preview thingy.
The limited run games 3 preview thingy.
Showcase. That's the word.
The limited run game 3. It's all on there. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Oh, so that's what it is. The LRG 3. Ooh, jeez. Oh. It's just starts playing.
Jeez almighty. That was 37 minutes. That felt like a long 37 minutes. I'm not going to lie. I watched the entire thing.
Yeah?
And, I don't know. I feel like a lot of people are...
I just don't really have that high of expectations. It's like, what games can you re-release? Like, that's all... Like, don't get me wrong. Like, what they do has a very limited scope, right? It's both limited run, but also limited scope. Like, they keep, unless you're like... Oh, snap. Unless they become...
Sorry.
No, I don't know. I mean, don't get me wrong. Like, I like the idea, but it definitely is romanticized a little bit to think that they're not going to run out of print.
100%. That's why they do stuff like A Boy and His Blob. I'm just saying.
What are you?
You can buy that game for $15. Why would you buy it again on a cartridge for $60?
Cause I don't know. It's cool.
Exactly.
Cause you like that game a lot. Does it come with does it come with a keychain or a little plushie?
I don't know. I'm sure the collector's edition did. But those are like three or like $250 or something.
Sounds tight. I want it. Give me that.
Okay, I picked a bad one.
But... Okay, yeah, I like A Boy and His Blob. That game didn't make a f-ing lick of sense to me when I was like 5 or 6 years old.
Oh man, none at all.
You like throw a candy and depending on the flavor of the candy, it would turn into different things and be like a trampoline, and then you jump on it and turn into a rocket and then shoot you back into like some other place with these like bouncing things, and you're like, what the hell is going on?
Yeah, like what the
and you're like dodging it, and it's the hardest like timed like movement. Anyhow, yeah, that game sucks.
Yeah. I'm not gonna lie, I never liked it, to be honest.
I always thought it was cool. I always thought it was like a cool, you could turn the blob into different things, cool idea.
Right
thing. I always knew that I wasn't getting it. I knew that I was missing something because I was, you know, I was like, I'm dumb. I'm a kid. I'm an idiot. I don't know anything works. So, yeah, I should go back and play it. See if I'm still just an idiot.
I feel like I did do that a couple years ago, and I'm still an idiot.
You're like, this game sucks. Like, it's just too hard. You're like, I don't know what these words mean. Strawberry?
What is a strawberry?
I only get one of these flavors. I can't even find... So, like, Polygon didn't even cover the limited run games thing, apparently. Right?
I don't think so.
Why wouldn't they? Is that not something they care about? Like, okay, I'm going to go...
I mean, did they cover the Evercade's presentation when they did one a couple weeks ago?
I don't know.
I feel like it's on the same level as that.
Okay, did Kotaku cover it?
But at least Evercade's thing was...
I like that Baldur's Gate 3, you can f*** a bear, and all of a sudden everybody's like, "Go, Baldur's Gate!"
And that's a big deal right now.
I'm just really sad that that's what it took for people to be like, oh, Lorien Studios, wow, makers of Divinity 2, the game's amazing, you should try it, but, like, who cares about that? You can f*** a bear?
Do you need assistance?
Oh, yeah.
Are you f***ing kidding me? where and it's people... actually just a man who's turned into a bear.
It's like, wait, are people excited about this or upset about this?
I'm sure there's more people excited than upset, but I guarantee there's some people who are upset, but everybody's excited. They're just like, you mean to tell me that man can both turn into an animal and then I can penetrate it? I don't know what else to say. That's what this is, right?
Is it?
Yes.
I've not heard this at all.
You have not heard about this? This is actually something that people are talking about. It's fucking stupid. I'm like, ugh. It actually makes me mad. Because I'm like, they have to include something like that. It's like Mass Effect all over again.
Where they're like,
oh, you're going to bang the alien.
You can f*** the aliens, right? You can f*** the androids. You can f*** the ship. But can you f***? Can you face?
You can try.
I shouldn't have opened the fly.
I'm Commander Shepard now. Because remember that was a big thing? Because they were like included the female Shepard in part two? Where you could like...
Oh, I do remember that.
Yeah, although that was a thing. That was a thing when BioWare did that. They're like, hey, Shepard can be a girl. And you're like, what the? You can do that? Anyhow.
Never did play those, though.
What?
Yeah. I know. Every time we bring this up, I'm still like, I just haven't played it.
I mean, they're super long games, and it'd be impossible to try to play them now, I think.
Like, 100%.
I'm sure they'd kind of hold up, because what is it? It's a third-person cover-based shooter with dialogue tree options in an RPG world. So it's not that hard of a gameplay to, like... It doesn't
just pick up and do.
Yeah, it's like Gears of War. It's Gears of War with RPG elements. So it's like it's a fun shooter.
Okay.
Just in general. And right. It's a fun customizable RPG where you're like, all right, I'm gonna upgrade my telepathy. I'm gonna get my bio thing so I can like hack people and stun them, and then I can like get my sniper rifle specialization so I can, you know, get a longer slowdown to get more headshots.
Mm.
So you can really like customize the build that you're making. You can like chain lightning through people or make them all rise into the air and then slow down. And then you can pick them off.
That's pretty sweet.
It's a fun game. Like, anyhow.
I've been playing Dead Space. I already beat that. But BioShock again.
Oh, that's a good one.
Because I've never beaten 2, and I've not even tried Infinite.
What? 2 is... I think 2 is better than 1, first of all. Yeah. Only because the mechanics were much better.
Mm.
Because you could actually... The way you had to, like... You could both use your gun and your plasmid. You didn't have to switch between them.
I got you.
Like you did in the first one.
Oh, because, yeah, you have to, like, put your hand down pretty much and be like... Oh.
Yeah.
Oh,
that
and awful. Then you have to hit the L1 to be like, wait.
Yeah, that drove me nuts.
Oh, I can't remember what.
But yeah, the big sister, all that stuff.
I'm a dork. But yeah.
And then Infinite is such a good, fun shooter. Like, it's that just... And the story, obviously, is sick. But just the set pieces, the like the mechanic, because they really like open it up more because it's in the sky and you get that rail thing and you're jumping around from rail to rail like da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
And aren't the big daddies like these crazy bird things pretty much?
Well, there's one, the songbird.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, there's only one.
Ah.
Well, yeah, I mean there was only one. Oh no, there's a bunch of big
daddies.
There's
a bunch
of
big daddies.
Well, in the second one, there's only one big sister, right? Is what it is.
Oh, okay.
But the, yeah. Ooh, spooky.
We just got haunted by a ghost.
The songbird is the one from Infinite, and that one's really cool. That game is super, super. It's just super.
Super duper?
Yeah, a lot of fun.
Sweet. And that's why I want to play it, and I felt like I wouldn't mind playing the first one again, so.
True.
Just doing it again on the PlayStation 4 this time.
Yeah, why not?
So.
Well, that's cool. What were we talking
speaking
about?
What is this?
Oh, we were talking about the limited run thing.
Exactly. Speaking of limited run.
Is this the list of stuff they announced?
No.
Where can you find that? Do you have to watch the fucking presentation?
I literally think you had to, and I even felt like...
Because you wrote down everything, right?
Yeah, I felt like that was going to happen, so that's exactly why I wrote it down.
Dude, mainstream media is is totally...
They're slacking.
Ignoring this. They're pushing their narratives about and silencing the voices of independent, like, limited-run games.
100%. Sorry, I was looking at Darth Maul climbing.
but, okay.
Yeah,
that's Batman. Let's see. That's definitely Batman, dude. Get out of here.
That's Batman?
Look at the cape, dude.
All right, fine. He's got a cape. You got a point.
Not only is it a cape, it's a really
it's a really Batman cape.
Okay. Anyhow.
But the list of games that they showed is pretty long. You're not going to know almost any of these names. But one of them is Castlevania Advanced Collection, which, of course, if you haven't just bought the digital version by now, you can wait another 2 years to get a physical one. So that'll be fun.
For what?
Castlevania Advanced Collection.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. I mean, it really is. It's cool. People are going to be excited.
So Circle of the Moon, Harmony of Dissonance. Is it just those two?
I think so.
Okay.
But I'm not sure, to be honest. I stopped paying attention to it because it's already out. Like, I already got mine on sale, like, months ago.
You loathe them so much.
I mean, I'm just saying. You can already have played the whole thing. It feels really late now.
Oh, because it came out digitally?
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's what they do. I mean, that's yeah, it's kind of lame, but that's... Oh, here we go. Here's each individual.
Oh, there you go. But
each
yeah.
individual thing. So if you go to their YouTube channel, you can watch each one of the trailers for these. They just have them in the video list, so... all right, so...
I mean, did you want me to go through all of them or just bring up the ones that I thought were interesting?
Yeah, I mean, just the ones that we think are interesting, I think.
I mean, they're doing a release of Rise of the Triad, which is awesome and ridiculous.
Yeah.
But, I don't know. It depends on how much that one is. I might pick that one up.
Dude, Gex Trilogy?
Dude, hell yeah. That was the very last one, and that's actually one of the few that I'm stoked about, because it is such a pain in the dick to play a Gex game on the PS1. And you know, if I'm saying that... It's a pain in the dick to play these games on the PS1. Because yeah. I love the PS1. But if we could get better controls for all the Gex games, I'd be f***ing stoked.
That's what I'm saying, dude. Like, sometimes the things that they're doing are good.
Yeah.
Like, I agree. A lot of it's unnecessary. I mean, the Shantae one, Shantae Advance, sure, whatever. I mean, sure.
It's apparently the real number two.
Yeah, whatever. But Toma?
Yeah.
Like the animation looked so much cleaner that you thought.
I thought it was a different animation. I was like, the whole time, I was like, this is different.
I was like,
there's something wrong. I like, it's the same, but it's not the same. And then, yeah, then we watched the real one again. And then I was like, oh, it's the same thing. It's yeah. just kind of blurrier.
I remember our cable would get like shut off or whatever. And I would just watch the like intro to the Tomba. And I was just like, hell yeah, this is tight. You ever do that? Just watch your like Tony Hawk videos. Like sometimes, like our cable would get shut off when I was a kid.
Dude, hell yeah,
or whatever.
Sorry, I was trying to think of other games that I would do that with as well. Onimusha had a dope like demo. Resident Evil Dead Aim had a really cool one because it
watched that. Like, hell yeah!
It like kicked in this like random heavy metal song. Yeah, dude, that's an arcade opener right there.
Dude, I used to just pop Skitchin' in. Dude, that song is fun.
Dude, hell yeah. We're definitely going to put that one up. Yeah, and then another one was I loved Sports Talk NFL Football. Sports Talk.
Yeah,
that was 93. Wild. Joe Montana's 93. Because that intro was awesome as well.
Dude, okay, so... Listen, the Jurassic Park collection's kind of cool. You can get the game for $5.
It depends on which ones are in there.
Well, it's going to have all of them, right? Like, six Experience, 8-bit, and 16-bit Legacy of Jurassic Park. So it's probably going to have the Super Nintendo and the Genesis version.
I hope it has the Genesis version as well. Because I don't think they showed it. I think the only ones you ever see are the Super Nintendo and the Game Boy.
It has to have the special edition of the Genesis one. Otherwise, it's stupid. Yeah. Why would you do it without that?
All the Jurassic Park
games. You could be the Raptor.
Right? All the Jurassic Park games on a Genesis were fucking lit. If you grew up at that time, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
And I could never beat the Raptor levels, dude.
They were hard.
I did the, I was able to do the, you're right, bro.
I'm telling you, it's the NES, Super NES, which are the same thing, except for one has cool corridors that you go down, and then the Game Boy. Nope, that was the Sonic, or Sega one.
Oh, there it is.
There's one.
There it is. Okay, it's on there. Yeah, because it's like, oh, it looked good, too. Did you see that? Look at. Where's this? Oh, where's that snippet?
I think I missed it. It's back a little bit more. Oh, that was the other one.
There it is. Oh, it showed it again?
I think they showed part of the intro where it's like, rah. Well, there it is. There you go.
Yeah, that looks stupid. But yeah, I could beat the Dr. Grant levels. Remember the rafting level? Where you'd have to go down, you're in the offices, and you're riding the river raft. And you'd have to like...
Was that the Super Nintendo?
No, that was the Genesis one.
That was Genesis? It's been so long. I remember I loved the Genesis one, though.
Jurassic Park Raft.
Maybe I didn't even make it that far, though. And maybe I was Genesis. Just so happy with the first two levels as a little turd.
Dude, this level was so freaking hard. Because you had to get the gas for the raft. And then actually like...
What?
You could take it down.
Oh, shit. Oh, what?
Dude, this was so hard. I could actually beat the Grant levels. Oh my God, we're just watching this dude die. But anyhow. Okay.
I don't know if I ever made it that far, to be honest.
Oh my God, this really triggers me. This was so hard, because you had to like get out to fight, and then you had to get the gas. Oh, get the gas.
You can only get hit once, it looks like.
Dude, so hard.
One hit wonder kills.
Game was stupid. I love it.
I think
that's what pterodactyls sound like, by the way. Pterodactyls that fly 3 feet off the ground in the jungle, by the way.
100%.
Under the canopy in the jungle.
Rainforest jungle.
Rainforest, 3 feet off the ground, just pecking your eyes out instantaneously. Like the same pterodactyl from Joust.
Oh, no. That's not an pterodactyl. That's an ostrich.
Oh, I'm sorry. The pterodactyl comes if you're on the ostrich too long.
Does it?
Yeah, dude.
I don't think I've ever gotten to that part.
What are you talking about? If you don't beat a level fast enough, the pterodactyl comes out.
Oh.
Dude, have you ever played... Did you just die too fast?
I feel like... That very well could be. That was, again, another game that I only played when I was tiny. Let's see.
I'm just talking shit.
Now I'm just trying to see.
Yeah.
I just thought it was another ostrich. Yeah,
pterodactyl. Here you go. Look at this. Infinite pterodactyl. There's a
pterodactyl
trick. But yeah, like, if you wait too long, see, he's just chilling. Here comes a pterodactyl. You don't remember this?
Oh, damn!
And what? It eats the ostrich's ass for some reason. I don't know what that's about. But anyhow, the pterodactyl normally just kills the shit out of you real fast. And it's like, it's kind of it's the timer.
I got you.
Because it just chases you. It's really fast and it always wins.
Yeah.
So.
I think I just always thought it was another ostrich. I never thought of it as a pterodactyl for some reason. That was straight up a pterodactyl. I don't know. Maybe I was just really dumb.
you're like that's not even kind of not a pterodactyl. That's exactly a pterodactyl.
All right.
You didn't believe me.
I didn't.
Like, you're like, no, you mean the ostriches? I was like, no, you're right. There are ostriches.
I just got Mandela effect.
There's a pterodactyl.
Telling you, that's totally different. That's freaking me out.
That's funny.
All right. I just thought it was one without a writer. Got pissed.
So, what else did they announce?
They announced the Gargoyles remaster, which they didn't show anything, but if you like that game, that's kind of one of those random 16-bit games as well.
Gargoyles, the...
On the Genesis.
Disney?
Yeah.
The Disney one? Oh, okay.
That's good.
Goliath?
Yeah. And you could, like, climb up the walls and stuff, and then...
Yeah. Damn, my buddy Craig... He was a big fan of the of the gargoyles, and he had a bunch of reptiles. He was like a snake guy and had like lizards and cheese. You know Craig.
I know Craig.
You know Craig. What's up, Craig? Anyhow, he named them all after all of the gargoyles.
That's pretty dope.
So, yeah, I don't remember all their names because they were his
Durhards,
and I don't care. But you know what? You go, Craig. I remember one of them was named Goliath. So there you go. I'm a great friend. I'm a really good friend.
So I think, yeah, the last one that I was super excited about was Clock Tower.
Yeah. That was always one of those games that I liked the idea of, but was too scared.
Yeah.
I don't like spooky games. You know that?
Get some, dude. I'm scary scared. Games are good.
I don't like being scared. And
apparently, they were saying it has never been released in America before, but weren't we able to play that at some point in time?
Maybe it's some version that's never been released in America? Right.
I guess. Maybe there was a fan translation that I played or something, but I feel like I played some of it.
Sure.
Hmm.
Yeah, I don't know. So they said that it's never been done
on the Super Nintendo here. Yeah.
Interesting. On the Super Nintendo.
Yeah.
Oh, that there was the first there one. Was. Yeah. You're right. It wasn't done here. They're right.
Yeah.
It's not Clock Tower on the PS1?
No, this is the very first one.
Oh, it's way forward.
Yeah, it's way forward doing it, so you know it's going to be done well. Freaking stoked. I feel like that's just going to be when I purchase digitally, though.
Yeah. I mean, sick. I don't care.
Like I said, I'm excited enough to just buy it digitally when it comes out, but I'm definitely not going to wait for a limited run version of it.
Yeah, we'll see. I mean, cool. Yeah, sweet. I know a lot of people like Clock Tower. I personally, like I said, sure, 16-bit spooky game is probably less actually spooky, but also just not, it's not my bag then, love.
Yeah.
It's not my bag then. I'm not afraid of no ghosts.
Yeah. Stinking ghost. Little short bastard with a big old scissor.
Coco Scissor Man.
Yeah. So, I don't know. I feel like that's the last one that I even cared about remotely. The rest of these were like, one of them they introed, making me think they were just going to re-release the CDI Zelda games.
Oh, true.
But then they're like, oh, those inspired this one, though. And then it kicked off into that one, the RZ or whatever.
RZ, yeah.
And I don't
looks
know.
Looks like, man, another just CDI platformer. And then there's the Plumbers Don't Wear Ties, which is just, I think, a joke game.
The first American graphic novel game.
Yeah, I mean, it's a joke game. It's like a meme game.
It's like a,
I don't know what this, Ninja Turtles music?
Yeah, they're just doing every Ninja Turtles game vinyl.
That's pretty cool. I don't know if you care about, I think that's cool. Personally, I mean, I'm a vinyl guy. You know what to give me for Christmas. And
ice cream?
Vinyl clothing.
Those are the most comfortable.
Vinyl socks. They get your feet real sweaty. Sorry, I'll stop.
I'll stop too, sorry. I was going to keep going. But yeah, that sounds pretty cool. I just wish, I don't know, that they would just do a collection sometimes. But then you know they are going to do one, but it's just going to be
collection of what?
Compounded, and they're just going to send them to you individually anyway.
Are they selling them individually?
Yeah.
I mean, so it's gonna be sure they have to, though, because I bet you there's so many different, like, I bet you each one is, like, quote, published by a different place or whatever, and so.
Although the cool thing is you can get CDs and cassettes as well.
Cassettes are pretty cool.
I might be tempted to get a cassette because I still have a car with a cassette player. So.
That's pretty sweet.
That'd be kind of fun. Just pick my favorite one. If it's like $20, I'll do it.
I got some cassettes right behind you, dude. I think they're like those yellow ones. Yeah, see them on top of the castle things?
Right there. Oh, yeah.
I can't remember what those are. They're like some sort of like, they're like storybooks or something.
Oh, yeah, the ones that came with the tape on the top, and it's like, I'll read a long storybook.
Yeah.
Got the, oh, shit.
Yeah, it's
that
OG.
You don't just have something. You got the one fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The haunted house from Disney, and then
I think on the other side is a different thing, right?
Is it really?
Yeah, this side is Record your world of sounds.
Record your world of sounds. I think.
Okay, maybe not. Maybe not. Children's Favorites, Volume 1.
I definitely have.
Old McDonald Had a Farm. The Hokey Pokey. She'll Be Coming Around the Mountain. Oh my. Dude, this is a hit after hit. This Old Man, Knick Knack Paddywhack.
Give a dog a bone.
I've Been Working on the Railroad. Three Blind Mice. And Oh Susanna. Dude, that one of those is a hit.
I've had that tape growing up.
I think that only had song list tapes.
Was like each one was. It's hit me. It's hit me. It's all coming back. My mom used to rock that thing all the time. And then she abandoned us, so I stopped hearing it.
You're like, now whenever I hear those songs, I just hyperventilate and get very anxious and just fall into a deep, deep depression, and I eat my fears.
I don't know, though. I feel
that
like...
That was funny. I feel like that
might be everything, though, that I feel was... really cool. The rest of it was just shovelware, the presentation.
I think it's a good presentation. I think you
know. I love the way they presented it too. I didn't talk about that yet. They actually presented it as if it was in 1995 or three. It was when the first E3 happened.
Sure.
It was so cornball, and I loved that part. That part was actually really fun. Like, it was so dumb and so cringe that it was just like, oh my gosh, this it really did feel like an actual presentation from E3 or something.
I mean, are there production times still just awful?
Oh yeah, they're the worst. My Sam and Max, the one with space or whatever, that one is over 14 months now.
That's a really long time.
It's too f-ing long.
That's a really long time. I mean, for Sam and Max, that's a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
On the Switch, like. I know you have the right cartridges.
I know you have it. And you're keeping it from me. You have it in a cupboard, and you're too lazy to ship it.
They even says it's ready to ship, and it's been like that for months. I'm just like, come on, you guys, hurry the up. I got my Doom in just today, actually. Let me see how long ago that happened. Because that one was, I think that one was real close to a year.
Yeah, I mean...
And all it was the basic one and a t-shirt. And the t-shirt, it's okay. I like our shirts better.
Is it screen printed?
Is it? It looked, I think so.
Okay. I'll have to take a look.
But the shirt itself
we'll have to investigate.
Like, if you know how awesome our shirts are, imagine that and then like the cardboard ones that really suck.
Yeah.
This is like in between those.
Sure. So it's like it's not quite a Gildan.
Yeah. But it's not
a Gildan, it's not a Bella Canvas. It's a Hanes. It's a Fruit of the Loom.
Yeah.
It's a Fruit of the Loom.
Yeah. So it's not bad.
It's like one of those dry fit Fruit of the Looms. Yeah, one of those.
Yeah. Let's see. Doom Eternal was September was when I purchased it. That was a minute ago.
That's a long time. That's almost a year.
Dude, for a big hit like Doom as well.
Like, and it's Doom Eternal?
Yeah.
What is it?
Doom Eternal on the Switch.
Oh, okay. How does it run?
Oh, I haven't... Like I said, I just literally got it today. I haven't even been able to open it yet.
Did this didn't get a release outside of that?
I don't think so. Like, you could get it digitally.
That's pretty sick.
Yeah. It's pretty dope. That's why I was excited. And this is a shirt that I got, too. I do feel like...
Oh, that... There's no way they screen printed that.
I feel like...
That's DTG.
Not screen print. Sorry, I was thinking the ones that we've been doing.
Press on ones.
Yeah. Or
well, these are
not these ones, but
yeah, the Nuggets ones.
Yeah,
the Nuggets ones. Yeah, so like DTG or DTF or something.
Yeah,
true.
Not screen print.
Yeah, we're talking about shirt science. Do you like shirts? We make shirts.
I really wanted to get that.
This is my shirt. Check it out, my shirt. Look, Pink Gorilla Games is my shirt. And
whatever.
This is screen printed, which is nice. They don't mess around. They like that nice quality. Oh, yeah, you're wearing your level 7 game shirt, and I got my Pink Gorilla one.
Gotta be repping.
Shout out to other local game stores and existing.
Yeah.
Existing in this business.
Good job.
In spite of the gaming industry.
Yeah. Bunch of f***s.
Yeah, they make it difficult. So, you know, if you're out there, other game store owners, you know, Godspeed.
Skull.
Oh, I'm all out of coffee. Oh, no, I'm not.
Ooh. That's a legit one right there.
There we go.
I do want that Doom skate deck, though. And I would like to actually learn how to ollie before I get too old.
What do you mean too old?
At like 50 and just like break myself when I do it.
How much is the skateboard?
Oh, I don't know. Those are gone now.
Oh, you can't get it?
No, it's limited run. You have like that 2 week window and then they're just like, oh, those are sold out now.
Well, they do that sometimes. Sometimes they're like, you can order it for 6 years.
Yeah, they don't.
Damn, that's a f***ing cool skateboard. You didn't order that?
No, dude, it's $75.
Are you crazy? That's not that bad.
Yeah, but on top of the t-shirt and the game, that would have been like $200 and some.
Okay, maybe that adds up a little, but
yeah.
Come on, man. That's a dope
It's a kick-ass skateboard, but man, can you imagine how long it's going to take for those people to get those? Holy crap.
It's never going to happen.
No.
Dude, I ordered skateboards once, and then after I paid for them, it was like 6 months. I was like, what?
Oh, yeah, that was when they were fast.
Dude, I need to find out like a place that can make skateboards. Cause
hell yes.
I want to do those ones with the...
The Bowser and the Mario?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, dude. I would totally love to design a skate deck.
Do it.
That'd be sick. All right.
Yeah, we're going to work
done,
on that.
Done and are done.
Done.
So I believe... I don't know. Tell us what you were excited about. If you even watched the limited run games presentation. If you hate them... Or if you're still cool with buying stuff from them.
Yeah, what do you have to say about this subject matter? Do you agree or disagree with all the things that we like or don't like? I didn't even cover the fact they did Rose and Camilla collection because I don't know what that is. So
all they described it as was, would you like to play
I'm
Knockout?
Right. I don't.
But instead of Mike Tyson, it's writings from Jane Austen because we got you covered. And then they went into it, and the whole time I think my brain...
That sounds dumb.
It like on itself or something. I was like, I don't know what's happening.
Your brain on myself now.
It hurt. So that was a lot of the shovelware kind of stuff. It was just like, this looks awful.
Right, right. All right, well, but, you know, congratulations to Limited Run for being in business still as well.
You better pick it up.
You're gonna lose. Just get the Salmon Max to him, please.
Hurry. Fuck. This is getting ridiculous. They're going to cancel it on me soon. I know it.
They always do.
Until next time.
Until next time.
Official sign off.
Signing off officially.
Haha. I didn't hit the mic that time.
I did.
Thanks for watching the Level 7 broadcast. Be sure to like and subscribe to get more videos just like this. And be sure to visit us at any Level 7 Games location to find all of your gamer needs, from video games and trading cards to even manga and tasty as hell coffee. For all of those and more, I'll see you there.
I just want my point and click adventures.